Today we thought we'll cover the entire program. How we have structured this sessions, I will request my colleague Dr. Khurdia to explain it to you.
We have structured this whole program, diploma program in value-added products from fruit and vegetables in two parts. There are 8 courses. So part 1 is dealing with the course 2, 4, 6 and 7. And part 2 is dealt with the course 1, 3, 5 and 8. Dr. Saluja will take the part 2 first and will review the whole all the 4 courses for your benefit. Dr. Saluja, please.
Thank you, Dr. Khurdia. Friends, you know, this 4 courses are the courses on food fundamentals, food chemistry and physiology, food microbiology, entrepreneurship, marketing. What I have done is, I have identified the competences which are required for these programs, and then what are the important topics which, as a student, once you pass out, you must know. Like, first thing is introduction to food science. So this will cover all the aspects. The important part is that what is food science? You must know the definition, what is food science. Then you also must know what is the food technology. Then what is the food chemistry is there? That is, like, it consists of moisture, carbohydrate, proteins, lipids. The basic definition about these things must be remembered to you. Then we come to the nutrition and digestion part of things. Why do we need nutrients like water, carbohydrate, proteins? What is the digestion process? What is the digestion system? Then what is the stability of nutrients when we process them? So you should have this aspect should be clear to you. Then how does the food spoilage take place? Like, whether it is a physical, it is a chemical or microbiological. What are the causes of food deterioration? It is because of insects, enzymes, oxygen or moisture. What type of foodborne diseases, once the spoilage takes place, which can occur to human beings, should also be known to you. Then in this only, the next important unit is food processing industry. Now, as a student of this course, you must know what is the status and prospects of the food processing industry, because the lot of scope occurs in this industry. Then what are the trends? What are the major food industries? What is the new food processing policy? So that aspect should be known to you. Like, what are the parts of food industry? We divide them into 2 parts. One is on the basis of the production, manufacturing, distribution and marketing. The other way of classification is based on the type of product line, whether it is a cereal, it is a meat, it is a dairy products, it's fruit and vegetable, sugar based, fat and oil, or non-alcoholic. So these type of industries should be known to you. Then what are the problems in the food processing area? There can be problems at the farm level, there could be problem at the distribution level, there could be problems at the processing level. So this, as a student, you must know what are the problems at farm level. Like, the production yield is less, the cold storage are not there, we are dependent on the monsoon for this purpose. So these are the problems at the production level. Then what are the problems at the distribution level? The storage and transport facilities are not available there, cold storages are not there. Then what are the problems at the processing level? That the import duty is very high, raw material cost and packaging material cost is very high, we cannot go for the organized marketing and advertisement for the products. There are different laws are there, multiple laws are there. Now we are coming with the one new law, but as such present, there are many laws are there. So these are the problems at the processing level. Now a national food policy has come, where the focus is what should be given to the farmers, what should be given to the processors. The vision has been prepared for them. How we have to couple them together along with the technology, along with the how it can benefit the environment, to the society, how the quality is to be maintained for the food products, how the cost has to be lowered, what are the system for the exporting the products. So this national food processing policy cover all the aspects of increasing the nutrition of the people at local level and for exporting the food products. So the basic features of the food processing policy which is covered in our unit should also be known to you. Then the next unit is food laws and associated bodies. We know the importance of Prevention and Food Adulteration Act. This is the basic law which ensures that the food product which is safe, which is sold, is pure and wholesomeness. Then who is the controlling body? The local health authority is the controlling body for this purpose. Similarly, related to fruit and vegetables, there is a fruit products order. So the basic feature of fruit product orders must be known to you. Then there are certain standards which are to maintain the quality, like Bureau of Indian Standards. So this aspects of Bureau of Indian Standards should be known to you. Similarly, there are international standards like ISO, International Standard Organization. Codex Alimentarius, which has come with the FAO and WHO for exporting the products, this also must be known. A new thing which you have must have, HACCP, Hazard Analysis and Critical Control Point. All the food processing industries, when you are processing, export the product, you have to implement this HACCP type of system. It is based on that you identify the hazards which can take place into the food processing line and what are their critical limits and how you can take care of them. So this is an emerging fact, an emerging dimension which you must remember. Then what are the good manufacturing practices? Then total quality management for the quality insurance. These are the two new concepts which the food processor has to maintain. These aspects should be known to you when you are a pass out graduate. Then the next important block is characteristics of edible agriculture products. This covers the four units: food, grains, fruits and vegetables, dairy, poultry, then commercial crops, all the aspects are there. Now food grains in all this unit is production, processing and value added products which can be prepared from food grains is given. The composition of important grains, particularly in our Indian context, should be known to you, that is like wheat, rice and important pulses. In the properties, water activity plays an important role. We must remember the water activity should be less than 0.6, the storage life will be good because bacteria can grow above 0.8 and yeast and mold can grow at water activity 0.7 is there. Then what are the unit operations? The important unit operations which as a fruit and vegetable student you must know is cleaning and grading, parboiling of the rice, then conditioning, drying, milling and oilseed crushing. Now important is the moisture level we should keep. For cereal it is 12 to 14%, for pulses 10 to 12, and oilseed 8 to 10% is there. Then what are the deterioration which can take place into the food grains based from environment is temperature, relative humidity and the storage, the gaseous composition. Then the biochemical changes which can take place because of the moisture and the fat content is there. Then how does it affect the quality of the grains? It affects the weight loss can take place, taste can change, color, odor, nutrition, acidity there can be there, rancidity can be there, there moisture content will increase. All these things affect the milling and the baking quality or even the whatever ultimate use we are going to use it. More important for us is the fruit and vegetable component is there. We know the importance of fruit and vegetable. They are known as the protective foods because they are good in minerals and vitamins. And our country is producing around 50 million tons of the fruits and 100 million tons of the vegetables. We are the second largest producer is there. But in the world trade, our component is only 2.3% is there. And the losses in the post-harvest is around 25 to 30%. With this losses, what is happening is the good nutrients is not available to our large population, and simultaneously we are not able to export the product. In organized sector we are only handling 2.3% of the production. Like 18,000 crore is the turnover, but in organized sector it is only 400. Rest of this is in the unorganized sector is there. So this what is emphasized is the fruit and vegetable, even though we are second largest producer, but in organized sector handling is very less, and then we are not able to export it also. And this has the potential of lot of manpower requirement. People can be given employment, but we are not able to take the things. Now Government of India has emphasized that its production will be in the organized sector from 2 to 4%, and the fruit and vegetable processing will increase up to 6 to 8%. So these are the basic features you should know. Then we come to the what is the fruit is there. It is known as the ripened ovary is there. We must know the difference between climatic fruits and non-climatic fruits are there. That non-climatic fruits, they ripen on the plant itself. They cannot be matured fully at the storage. But climatic food get matured during storage also. Like apple, banana, these are the examples of climatic fruits and climatic fruits and non-climatic fruits are there. Then the composition on average level, the moisture content is very high. Around 80 to 90% is the moisture percent. The protein and fat components is very less. They are a good source of digestible carbohydrates. Then vitamin A and C are also very good. Then they give the color, flavor component is there. They provide the astringents, bitterness and aroma also there is there. These are the phenolic compounds which provide this astringent flavor. And this also provide resistance to pathogens and stress. That's why when the fruits are given the name protective foods. Then how to judge the maturity of fruits and vegetables are there. Now, if you pluck the fruits at the early stage, they will be lacking in the flavor and they will be lose the moisture rapidly. But if you do the late harvesting, then they will be overripe and they will have a short post-harvest life is there. So we should, the objective is how to select the, there are three methods to see the maturity of fruits. One is physical, then chemical method, and then the biochemical method is there. Physical method means by visual observations we do the things. Chemical by doing the chemical analysis. Biochemical particularly release of the carbon dioxide and ethylene is important. Then cultural practices also make an important impact on the quality of fruit. What are the cultural practices which impact, like soil water management, canopy management, fruit thinning is there, then dose of minerals and application, chemical spray, pest management, all these factors can also control the quality of the final product is there. Like what is the pre-harvest treatment where we can improve the quality of fruit and vegetable? One of the component is level of calcium in the fruit. It is an important part. If the calcium is low, then there could be lot of defects, like you must be remembering bitter pits in apple. These type of defects can occur. Now how can we increase the level of calcium in the fruits? By application of zinc and boron into the soil, it can increase. If the level of calcium is appropriate, it will increase the firmness, soluble solids, organic acid, ascorbic acids, and even reduce the disorders into the fruits and vegetables also. Do and do nots of quality harvest. You would pluck the fruits, particularly when the market need is there and proper maturity stage is there. This is the important point is there. Then don't use the hands, use the proper equipment, and then the word where do you collect the things, they should be hygienically maintained. Proper store places of the paper should be there, and they should be plucked in the early morning or late evening, it should be there. They should be put properly safe in the shades. So these are the things. The field sorting and packaging should be promoted because it adds lot of value into the products. Now, once the what the treatment you can do at farm level is there. Removal of the field heat is important. It has been observed that if you lower the temperature by 10 degrees centigrade, the shelf life of the fruit and vegetable will be increased, almost double the thing is there. So what we do is pre-cooling is must is there. Then disinfection by giving them the hot water treatment or by the potassium permanganate or calcium chloride. This can be done at the farm level is there. At the post-harvest management techniques which are there, sorting is there, cleaning with water, particularly with the chlorine water, then trimming, waxing, grading, packaging, labeling, storage and transportation. Friends, you must have heard the retail marketing is coming in a big way by a lot of multinationals, and even the Indian companies are also coming. So if a fruit grower, if you can identify that how to do the sorting, how to properly pack them and transport them, there could be a lot of value addition to the fruit and vegetables. To give the example, sorting at farm level, what it will do, it will reduce the cost of transportation and handling of the onward produces there. Unwanted produce could be avoided. Like we gave the example, if the cauliflower is there, you can properly sort it out and trim it, the transportation cost will be very less and unwanted material could be avoided will be there. Waxing is another important thing which can be there because it reduces the rate of respiration, which is the problem which gives the maturity, very fast maturity, or the rate of reactions which spoilage of the fruit and vegetables can take place is there. So these are the important points there. When we do the packaging, we have to make sure that the whatever packaging material is there, there should be sufficient strength into this. Then it should be good aeration should be there to remove heat and the humidity is not there. It should be attractive and economical is there. For temporary transportation, around 90 to 95% humidity at room temperature 10 to 15 degrees centigrade, what we call the cool chamber, is good enough. And for the bigger, for then you want a longer storage period, nowadays the modified atmosphere package or controlled atmosphere package, where the oxygen percentage is less than 5%, or even the carbon dioxide percentage increase, could provide a good alternative there. Now, then the processing, what are the components? When we do the processing, the main thing is we have to remove the water component has to be kept minimum. And the other objective is we can produce a range of value added products there. Now, how can we reduce the chemical potential, particularly by heat, by addition of solute, or by fermentation is there. Then we come to the next component is the dairy, poultry, meat and fisheries. As far as fruit and vegetable student, there will be less focus, there should be less focus on dairy, but some of the important points you must know as a food technology student, that India ranks first in the dairy cattle. Milk production, you know, in our country is highest, 91 million tons. The egg production is also very good, and in the fish production also we are very good is there. The milk component is basically, the basic components of the milk are fat, protein, lactose and minerals is there. The average composition also must be known to you. Fat percentage is 4%, protein 3.4%, lactose 4.6%. This is the composition. It also contains water, around 86% is there. And in a dairy industry, you must remember the man who gave the white revolution, Dr. V. Kurian is there. What is the milk importance? Because it is an ideal food. It has all the nutritive value, and it has the bone forming minerals, vitamins. So it is a good for the infants, for the growing children. So that's why importance is given to the milk is there. Nowadays, focus is taking place on the clean milk production, because when the country has a good production, but the focus has to shift on the clean milk production. So what are the parameters for clean milk production should be known to you. The basic processing is there, is the reception, chilling and storage of milk. Milk separation and pasteurization, these are the three basic things there. The milk which you get in the market is normally pasteurized when you take from the any organized dairies there. That means the milk has been heated to 72 degrees centigrade for 15 seconds is there. These are the milk processing and type of products, because it is known to you, like butter, cheese, frozen dairy products, khoa, chana, ghee, these are the products which can be prepared is there. Similarly, poultry, because now the poultry, the egg composition is, cell is there, albumin is there, and yolk is there. Egg contains about 2 parts white and 1 part yolk by weight is there. It contains good fat, fat-soluble vitamins is there. The 12% protein, 11% fat is there. And the quality factors which affect the egg size are also should be known to you. Then we come to the next component, particularly the nutritional block is the, what is the, this has the nutritional aspects, food for growth and repair, anti-nutritional factors should be known to you. What is the importance of nutrition? Why do we take it for growth, for development, and to lead a healthy life is there. These things should be known to you. What is the basal metabolism? How much energy is required? Like for 65 kg adult person, we need 3000 kilocalories per day is required. How much energy we get from different components of the food? Carbohydrate gives around 4.1 calories, 9, and the proteins also 4 calories. This is when we do the calculations, because some energy is lost in the digestion and metabolism. So we take the average value 4, 9 and 4 for the carbohydrates, fat and proteins are there. The nutritive value of vegetables and fruit must be known to you, because this course is basically dealing with the fruits and vegetables. So they have the high water content, low protein is there, and they provide that the classification is green leafy vegetables, root and tubers and other types of vegetable. Now, what is the nutritional importance of all the vegetables should be known, should be well known to you, particularly like green leafy vegetables, root and tubers, and what are the other vegetables which are good in vitamin C and fiber should be known to you. Similarly, the nutrient value of fruits, because of the good vitamins and mineral contents, for good fruits it must be known to you. And they also contain dietary fiber. This is an important component of the fruits is there. When we prepare the food diet, so a food pyramid is used. So you must know that how the food pyramid is there and how it can be used for the preparation. Nowadays, nutritional labeling is becoming an important component. The labeling is to be done if you are any food which you add some new nutrients or which you claim for any nutritional purpose. So nutritional labeling is becoming must. And labeling helps to the people that they can identify to the consumers that what they are eating, to the processors also that what does it contains is there. Then comes to the nutrients part that we have explained. It is the carbohydrates, proteins, fat, vitamins and minerals. These are the components are there. What is their role into the diet? What is the importance of food flavor? And what is the importance of food color? This should be known. Then the thermal processing is important. We normally give the, in any food processing, we give the thermal processing, but there is a loss of nutrients take place. So we have to balance in such a way that the loss of nutrients is less and we can preserve the life is there. Blanching, when you do the even simple blanching, the water soluble vitamins go into the water. Similarly, pasteurization helps in destroying the pathogenics, but then some nutrient loss can take place. Similarly, the canning is there in where the heat treatment is given more severe because the shelf life is more, but it destroys some of the microorganisms. Then we come to the keeping quality. Once you harvest the fruit and vegetables, they continue to respire. So we have to see that the keeping quality is extended by putting at low temperature and the low humidity. The growth of microorganisms has to be reduced. Enzymatic activities has to be reduced. These are the things. Nowadays, more of the health foods, organic foods, traditional foods are coming to the market. So what are these products should be known to you. We have explained that the new concept which is coming in packaging, particularly like modified atmosphere package, should be known to you. What type of losses can take place in the fruit and vegetable if they are not properly stored should be known to you. And these are the factors which causes spoilage. We can classify them into physical, physiological, thermal, microbial, chemical, insects. The physical factor we mentioned, particularly temperature, oxygen, and the level of oxygen is more, that the spoilage will be more. Temperature is high, the spoilage will be more. These are the similarly physiological factors, particularly respiration rate. If any conditions where the respiration rate is more, it will get mature fast. In the maturing fast, the starch concentration will decrease and it will change to the sugar amount. The acidity and the pH will also change into the things. So this should be known. In chemical factors, pesticide and the poisonous material should not enter into the food. Particularly like plastic packaging or even sometimes the plastic processing also, some of the can occur. So this we have to take care. We should have to take care of the insects and pest is there. Now the major biochemical changes which take place should be known, particularly with the rate of respiration, water content, carbohydrate, organic acid and pH. This should be known to us. Similarly, what are the microbiological factors should be identified. Then these are the post-harvest handling operations, pre-cooling, washing, cleaning, trimming, sorting, grading, curing, sizing, waxing and packaging. What are the preservation techniques? Now, first preservation technique is by delay of the microbial decomposition. Then second is by killing the microorganisms is there. And then self-decomposition of the food by killing the enzymes. This is the third. Fourth method is prevention of damage by the insects. These are all the preservation techniques are based on these four things. We can preserve the fruits and vegetables by high temperature, by low temperature, by chemicals, by drying, by filtration, carbonation, salt and sugar, fermentation, acids, oil and spices, antibiotics and irritation. So examples are there, and type of food products which are prepared is also known to you. Some of the anti-nutritional factors has to be identified. Then the food can be contaminated by bacteria, by mold, by yeast and by viruses. So some of the examples should be known. The food, can be present in the food. They can be natural toxins, they can be come from the microorganisms. Mycotoxin is from the mold which is coming, and from the environmental also. Food of infection, what happens when we contain a large number of pathogens are ingested along the with the food, it is known as the food infection, like cholera or dehodia. These are the known as the food infection examples are there. The associated term is food poisoning, when the our system gets spoiled, like gastroenteritis or these type of things, food poisoning by the microorganisms, examples should be known to you. So we call them the foodborne diseases based on the food infection or food intoxications. These are the examples of the some of the foodborne diseases is there. Nutritional deficiency also, if the food is not taken properly, there could be vitamin A deficiency, iron deficiency, iron deficiency. So what type of disease it causes should be known to you with the this. Then we come to the quality aspects of the things. Quality is becoming very important, particularly when we are exporting the food products is there. Now there are, for this, what are the quality assurance codes, what are the grades, what are the things should be known. The one thing which is coming has changed the thing, shelf life and dating of foods. We must give the shelf life and that how much date it will be there, that shelf life will be there. This has become a very good thing to for the consumers. We say that shelf life is the time required for food product to reach to the unacceptable quality. So a food processor has to identify the dating system, that how much the time it will be there is there. Then the causes of food deterioration have been explained to you again. So this is important, by growth, role of microorganisms, role of enzymes, insects, inappropriate temperature, the increase in the moisture, oxygen level, these are the things are there. What are the antimicrobial agents which could be used into food is also well declared. Sulfites, nitrates and nitrate can be used, benzoate and sorbates can be there. Then what are the food safety issues should be known to you, what is the food safe and what are the additives, antibiotics, fertilizers, irritation should be avoided into there. Then what is, how do we define the adulteration, what is known as intentional and what is known as incidental adulteration should be known. What is example of these things are there. What are the different food laws ranging starting from the PFA and up to the milk and milk product order, who are the bodies which are controlling them, what are the, these things should be known to you. Then we come to the food constraints, which covers the these components into detail: carbohydrate, lipids, protein, enzymes and water, vitamins and minerals. So their role in the balanced diet and what is the like basic components, their definition, what are the carbohydrates should be known to you. Like what are the monosaccharides, what are the examples of monosaccharides, what are oligosaccharides, that is it contains 2 to 10 monosaccharides per molecule. Disaccharides, example of maltose, lactose, fructose, raffinose, because these are important in respect of the fruit and vegetable, so must be known to you. Then degree of sweetness of the different sweeteners, what are the polysaccharides which are present into the fruit and vegetables, starch, pectin, gums which are present, the role of lipids in the fruit and vegetables, what are the saturated and unsaturated fatty acids, how the unsaturated fatty acids helps us in the for the our dietary system, particularly in reference to the heart diseases. So these things should be known to us. Similarly, proteins, they are the main building blocks. What are the amino acids are known as, or how do we call them, the lipoproteins, what is the conjugated protein, what are the derived proteins, so this should be known. How does the denaturation take place? It is an important component of the food components. So whether there is a change in the biological activity or not, so this should be known to you. What are the non-enzymatic changes, like maillard browning is there, by heating. And similarly, with the help of the enzymes, what are the changes take place? What are the essential amino acids and what are their level present into the our system is there? What is the role of enzymes into the particular fruit and vegetables is there? Then the water, importance of water, because this is the major the component which can cause the spoilage. It influences the food spoilage, and we have to see that water activity is as minimum as possible is there. Then how does the water quality also affects the things? Like, to give you example, the cola drinks, the main problem has come with the water quality. So how the potable water should be available whenever you're using the any processing is there. So what type of the quality potable water should be there, level of hardness is there, what type of hardness, temporary hardness and permanent hardness, what are the factors which cause them should be known to you. So what are the quality of water, we classify them based on the ppm of calcium carbonate. The type of microbiological quality is also important. So coliform count should be less than one, it should be there. Along with this, the color, odor, taste and turbidity should be quality. Similarly, coming to the vitamins, they are very much important in the fruit and vegetables, because what we call them the protective foods, it is because of the major minerals and vitamins are there. The what are the fat soluble vitamins, you must be knowing A, D, E and K. What are the type of diseases they cause and what is their sources, it must be known. Similarly, for water soluble vitamins also, what are their name, chemical name, what are the diseases they can cause, what are their sources should be known to us. And similarly, vitamin C, and this is there. Similarly, for the minerals also, because they are inorganic in nature and our body contains about 24 minerals. So what are the sources, particularly calcium, phosphorus? So it is more of general knowledge what you are knowing, but you must know in reference to your fruit and vegetables what is there. Then what are the food additives, what we can add into the things? Like, these are the type of the additives: preservatives, antioxidant, coloring agent, sweeteners, nutritional additives which you can add. Preservatives are two types, we know, class 1 preservatives, and then there is a other two type of preservatives are there. So this definition should be known to you. Then how do we select the preservatives, and what type of, like benzoic acid, benzoyl, what is their level is there, and on what it will act, whether it will act on yeast, whether it will act on microorganisms. So it must be, so depending upon the food, nature of the food, the type of microorganisms which can grow and type of the preservative which you have to select, it has to be based. So like sulfur dioxide could be better in some food, root and vegetables, benzoic acid could be better in some. So the level should be there. Similarly, what are antioxidants? Antioxidant problem is not there in fruit and vegetables, but if you have to use some health food and you want to increase the high percentage of fat, then what type of antioxidants has to be used should be known to you. Similarly, acidulants are used, like they have the flavoring agents, buffering agents, preservation, like citric acid, malic acid, tartaric acid, how much we have to use. There is a PFA permitted limits are there, it should be known to you. Then the coloring agent also, this is very important. What are the naturally prescribed the PFA and what is their level should be known to us. Synthetic colors also are allowed, but their level and what it is to be there, this should be known to us. Similarly, what are the flavoring agents which are allowed and which are natural and which are like natural identical flavoring substances, and what are the artificial flavoring substances should be there. Sweeteners, what are the sucrose alternatives which are available should be known to us, which we can use, like sorbitol, xylitol, isomalt, how much saccharin, how much we can use them. Similarly, emulsifying agents, anti-caking agents, clarifying agents, which you have to use. Next, we come to the microbial spoilage, because there are two things which affect the shelf life of the fruit and vegetables. One is the water and second is the microorganisms. Like type of microorganisms, what is the difference between bacteria, algae, fungi should be known to you. What are the factors which affect the microbial growth should be known to you. Like type of food, moisture, pH, proper handling is there, minimum mechanical damage should be there, remove the physical, washing them properly, there should be no spoilage, so this should be there. How can we prevent their microbial spoilage? By cleanliness, sanitation of equipment, inactivation or controlling. So this should be known to us. Then method of food preservation, again the methods are common by heating, by drying, freezing and drying, then the heat treatments, boiling, pasteurization, sterilization. These are the treatment. Difference between the pasteurization and sterilization, that pasteurization kills only the pathogens, while sterilization kills all the spores is there. Shelf life is more than 6 months in the sterilization method is there. Then method of drying, the basic method is the sun drying method is there, but nowadays mechanical methods are also there. Then how can we do the plate count? This should be also known to us. Then we come to the last course, which is the entrepreneur skills or the marketing skills are there. Earlier it was thought that the entrepreneurs are not, cannot be trained, but now it has been well established that entrepreneurs can be trained. By training we can develop them. So what are the, what is wage employment, what is self-employment, what is entrepreneur, who is entrepreneur? So this basic definition should be there. Then what are the, when you want to become an entrepreneur in food, so for what is the first stage is there, that where you can get the training, like this is the IGNO, you are doing the course is a good example. Second, some of the important features is from where you can want to get the raw material, where the market is there, what is the price, how you will transport is there. The your business should start where the raw material is available easily, because there the lot of moisture is there. If you can reduce the moisture percentage at the beginning level, you can save the lot of the transportation cost is there. Then type of packaging, the type of people are available to handle the machines, these are the things are there. Then preparation of project report, so all these things have been covered. Like I mentioned, entrepreneur skills are becoming important, and these are more of values, attitude and motivation which can change the people attitude. Like what are the, these are the things which we expect that student has to inculcate in themselves: self-concept, particularly risk-taking capacity, then innovation should be there, information seeking could be there, faith in planning. These are certain the things which is there. Now then the, we come to the, what is the business idea, what is how we define the business, then how do you get the different sources of business idea. You can get it from the market report, you can get from the consumers. There are now the market reports are available from the even Ministry of Food Processing side also. They have prepared the project reports also. That is the entrepreneur aspect. Then we come to the marketing aspects of the this concept. That what is the need in marketing? What are the wants? What is the exchange take place? And what is the component of the market? Because the marketing is the important component is there. Many of our traditional skills and the workers, and they are not able to market the products, and they are not able to survive in the system is there. So how do you segment the market? Marketing targeting has to be there. Then what are the marketing functions? We call them, they have the three main functions: function of exchange, functions of physical supply, and facilitating function. This is important is there. In exchange mean where the buying, assembling, selling is taking place. When we say the physical supply, all our transportation, storage, warehousing is come. And when we say facilitating function, we can come into the like advertising, marketing, packaging is there. Like traditionally we are thinking only market is a buying, assembling, selling function is there. No, it has been divided into three components. So what, these are the marketing function. Then the important, like you know, the four P's of the marketing. What are the four? Product mix, price mix, place and promotion. These are the important things there. Product mix is very important. Product mix mean you in whatever the industry you have set up, you have to see that the product mix is of proper type, so that the you are able to effectively utilize the machine component, labor component, and in the market also the product shelf life is there. How do you do the pricing as compared to your competitors are there, and the how do you do the promotion? These are the, what we said, the four P's of the marketing mix is product, price, place and promotion. These are the important things as a new entrepreneur you have to focus on to this. Then how do you start the business? An important business plan is needed. As you're preparing for exams, you're preparing your study plan. Similarly for business plan also. So this provides that framework is there. You can initiate your developments. You can strengthen your facilitate your financial assistance, appropriate technology can be selected, what support you can get it, what the knowledge and government regulations are there. These are the important feature. Then when this comes the project report, how do you prepare the project report is there. It has many components, economic components, ecological components, technical part, financial part, managerial aspects. So these things should be there. So we see that whether it is economical viable, it is a marketing viability is there, financial viability is there. The most important component is the financial viability, where we see the cost of the project, sources of finances are there, then the what are the different types of ratio, then the payback period, this should be known to you. Then the concept of the product life cycle is also there. Then the pricing objectives should be also known, that how do you survive into the market. Then type of intermediacy, whether I explained that nowadays direct retail marketing is coming into the picture, and with where the scope of the new entrepreneur, particularly fruit and vegetable, who can do the sorting and packaging at the home level or at the field level, could be important component is there. These are the component is there. Then the promotion mix also we have explained. So these are the basic features of all the four courses. The important facts we have covered in the review of the courses, that is what is entrepreneurship, what is the marketing, going back, what are the important nutrients, how the spoilage takes place, what are the causes of the food spoilage, how do you process them, what are the important processing parameters, what is their role, what are the nutrients they give it, and what are the basic composition of the our new food processing policy, what is the food science, what is the food technology. So these aspects should be known to you when you complete the course. I think with this basic we have reviewed all the four courses which we have structured into the these things, that is food fundamentals, food chemistry and physiology, food microbiology, entrepreneurship and marketing. So if these aspects are known to you, I think you will be able to become a good entrepreneur into the fruit and vegetable business. I think Dr. Khutia, we have covered very well.
You have reviewed nicely this one also, so all the four courses, so the student can understand what are the subject output can be gained by going through these courses. So the student can going through this all the eight courses of the diploma program, they can understand what are the outcome of this course, how they can improve their skill and knowledge, so they can better prepared for an entrepreneurship or a supervisory job in a government or private factory or anywhere that is they have gained this knowledge and skill. Or through this skill and knowledge, they can start your own entrepreneurship, enterprise, and become a party. We can provide the more employed generation to the other persons who are having this knowledge, and they can give the further employment to the rural areas, to their fellows also. So this will help in that way to improve their skill and then knowledge. And the food processing care concern, that is a value addition in the fresh produce as well as through the processing of the fruit and vegetables into the variable processed products, which can have the great shelf life. And this way, this course will help them to improve their knowledge and skill. I hope the student have learned something and they will be gainful, and it will help them to answer some of these questions when they appear in the term and examination also.